Bruria, the wife of Rabbi Meir in the time of the Talmud, was a brilliant woman, great scholar. Rabbi Meir would consult with her many issues of halacha, many issues of Talmud. In addition, moral behaviors. And the Gemara tells the following story. It's a Gemara Brachas. That a certain heretic came to Bruria and asked her a question. There's a verse in the prophecy of Yeshaya HaNavi, chapter 54, which is the first verse of this week's Haftarah, where there the pasuk says like this, Rani Yakora lo yolada. Sing, you barren woman who has not born, who hasn't given birth. Burst into song and jubilate. You have not experienced birth pangs. And the heretic says, she should celebrate because she hasn't given birth. She should celebrate because she didn't have birth pangs. Which mother doesn't want, which woman doesn't want to have children, notwithstanding the birth pangs? What's there to celebrate? So Bruria tells him, this is what happens when you only read part of it. Why aren't you reading the rest of the verse? Because the rest of the verse, she says, Amar Lei, so she told him, Shatya, you fool. Shvele Sefer Dekro. Look at the end of the verse. Dirsiv, there it says, Ki Rabim b'nei Shemeimo m'mnei Be'ula Amar Hashem. For the children of the desolate one are more than the children of the married woman. Simple meaning is, you will see in the end that you won't be desolate and there will be so many more children than those who have children presently. But Bruria says it has also a deeper meaning, another meaning. And she says what it means is, Rani Knesset Yisrael, celebrate the Jewish community, Shedoim Eli Isha Kor, which is compared to a barren woman. That hasn't given birth to children like you, heretic. That we have given children that are proper children, God-fearing children, children that we can pride with rather than children that bring unpleasantness, rather than children that are heretics. Discussion in the Talmud. What does all this mean? What is the idea here when this is the week of consolations? What is the Haftarah telling us? Then let's look at another verse. Torah brings in over here the flood of Noah, the Mabul. But God says, just like I promised I will never bring the flood again, so I promise I will eventually redeem you. And in fact, this Haftarah is read on Parshas Noah and on this week, the fifth week of the 7 weeks of consolation. In a certain way, the high holidays are sandwiched between Parshas Ki Tetzeh, Parshas Noach, and we have this Haftarah. Briefly, we are in exile. What is the purpose of exile? We're not giving birth. We don't see growth. We don't see redemption. Darkness. Jerusalem lays barren, so to say. There's a flood, destruction. A few who survive. Says God, what is the purpose of the flood? It was to cleanse the world, to prepare the world for a purified world. Says God, the same thing. Exile. That fact that Jerusalem is barren, meaning that it's in exile, it's all to prepare for the beautiful, luscious growth and fruit, so to say, spiritual aspect of the redemption. And that's what Bruria says. It may look to you barren. Why? Because you don't appreciate the moment of exile, the difficulties of exile. Let's see, you just look at the suffering, you look at the poverty, you look at the destruction of the time of the temple, says, but no, at the time of the exile. But no, says Bruria, All this is to show, to bring about the ultimate redemption, the ultimate goodness, the ultimate revelation which comes from these moments of exile. And that's what God says. I'm sandwiching in high holidays in between those two haftorahs, because what are all the whole high holidays all about? A time to reflect, a time to rejoice, a time to think, a time to connect to godliness, a time to appreciate our mission, a time to appreciate our responsibilities, which is all about what? The birth of the new world, the birth of rebirth of Jerusalem. God, you say, Rega Kotenas of Ticho, it's a short moment. It's pretty long. For a short moment to us, it's long. We're ready to light the Shabbat candles today in Jerusalem at 6:28 and here in Montreal at 7:20. And these lights should blend with the lights of Zion, with the light of the ultimate redemption.